to an ABC 7 of Hurricane Ian recovery. I'm Brenna Weick alongside Jeff Butera. And now we are joined by Superintendent of Lee County Schools, Dr. Christopher Bernier. Thanks for being here.
Thank you for having me.
Let's start with this. I know that you are new to Lee County. You were out in Las Vegas for a couple years, but I also know you've been in Florida since going back to the late 80s, correct? You were in the Orange County Public School System?
Yes, sir.
So I know that you lived through all the hurricanes of 2004, and I grew up in Orlando, so I remember Hurricane Gordon knocking out school, Hurricane Floyd knocking out school, any number of issues. What is it like to be back in Florida and almost immediately have to do something like this? And how are you doing with everything?
Personally, we're doing fine. We're blessed. I've had an opportunity to be out in the community via helicopter and other manners and means, taking opportunities to land on the barrier islands to visit schools. Been out of the shelters, taking care of people, making sure my shelter principals and other people are helping this community. But this is a historic event in our community. It is larger than most people can imagine, and unless you're on the ground in Lee County, I don't think you understand the gravity of the situation we're dealing with.
That's the truth, yeah. Tell us, if you wouldn't mind, giving us a status update on our schools. We have many, many throughout Lee County. I'm sure some of them had to have sustained some damage.
So when the storm began, before the storm even began, we were already in our own internal EOC process. We planned over the weekend not only for the approach of the storm, but getting the shelters ready. But then also we planned post-storm and how we would start the recovery period as quickly as possible. I have an amazing team. We've been hard at work all weekend. We have done the cursory, quick, initial assessment of all of our buildings. We've broken them into low, meaning they don't need a lot of work, we perceive, to medium, to high. Mm-hmm. And unfortunately, some in the high category may face total replacement.
Wow.
We are now have building inspectors that were on the ground as early as today, and they're out in our schools doing the official assessment of those buildings. You know, we're public school educators. We kind of know what we're looking for when we walk into a building to know if it's inhabitable, but we need that professional certification in order to move forward.
Do you envision a phased-in approach where some of the students who go to schools that suffered more minimal damage might be going back first, or is it going to be everybody all at once?
This is a transitional and developmental opportunity. It is ripe with plans and thoughts and ideas right now. We have a 5 o'clock meeting this afternoon with the Department of Education. We'll be working with them, leveraging some of their resources and some of their connections, because there will be aspects to which we want to make sure these students get back as quickly as possible. Mm-hmm. Our seniors were students who were freshmen and sophomores when COVID impacted them. We were off to an amazing start of the school year when this storm decided to make landfall in Lee County, and we need to get our young people back in school as quickly as possible. Mm-hmm. But it is a transitional and developmental program. We are looking at tiered approaches. We're looking at all different options so that we can get our students back as quickly as possible.
What would you say to parents who maybe are concerned? We were just looking at the Sanibel School, looking to see if there's damage there. For example, students who are not going to be able to go back to their school, can they expect, we actually have pictures on the right side of your screen for those who are watching and able to see these pictures of some of the destruction. Jeff, you were mentioning maybe not as bad as we expected.
It doesn't look as bad as I was envisioning, to be real honest, as these pictures were coming out.
I was on the ground. Some of these pictures are mine, along with the principal, along with a member of my construction team, and thank you to the sheriff for flying us out to these locations. My guess is Sanibel School probably took between 5 to 8 feet of water throughout the entire building. Mm-hmm. So while you see just wet and dampness and walls still standing, without the ability to get out there and dry it out very quickly,
yeah,
we know what's going to start to happen next.
Mm-hmm.
So we are going to have to get out, continue to assess that building. We'll be flying building inspectors out as well, and we'll get an update on the Sanibel School. I think what the question really is since we know they're not going to be going to school there,
exactly, yeah,
what are we going to do moving forward? Mm-hmm. We're committed in our school district to be looking at these schools as families and communities. They went to school together. Mm-hmm. When we transition them off island to wherever we can continue to educate them, same principal, same teachers, same students, mm-hmm, as best we can. There will be some people who leave Lee County and don't return. This is be the one thing that they just couldn't overcome, and they're going to decide as students, as families, as teachers to live somewhere else.
Mm-hmm.
But moving those school buildings as a whole unit and keeping that learning community together is our top priority.
So you're saying most likely a temporary solution, but with a priority of trying to keep cohesion among keeping students with their teachers, keeping communities together if at all possible.
Communities together in a safe learning environment that's sensitive to the community's need, and then is the best process, what's the best process forward for us to make sure that we do this as quickly as possible and as effectively as possible.
Sure, and I'm sure a lot of parents rely on school for childcare. You know, they have to go to work still, even though the schools are closed. So what would be your message to parents who are wondering, how long do I need to figure out temporary childcare, or is the school district able to offer any alternatives?
I think the important thing for parents to know is we are committed to reopening our schools as quickly as possible. That's foremost in my thought. It's what the first thought when I get up in the morning, is my last thought when I go to bed. Our children need that opportunity to continue their education. They've already been impacted by 2 years of COVID. And again, we were off to a great start, and now they're being impacted again. We have to work, we have to find a way forward, and this school district and this superintendent is committed to do that. This Thursday, I've asked my team to have an operational update so that we can make a decision about the week to come. We are taking this on a week-by-week basis, and if we can get to a tiered system where some of them will open, I think our families will appreciate being able to open and then taking care of our kids who we need to continue to support until their school buildings are ready.
I think back to the first day of school. My daughter started kindergarten in Lee County this year, and I talked with her principal, and I remember that first day. She said she was just so excited for what she felt like was going to be a normal year, because the previous 2 years with the pandemic, nothing had felt normal. And the reality is that that impacted the instruction of our kids. And now we've got something else that might flummox this. Obviously, you want to get kids back to school, but what do you think this is going to do for the learning of our children?
I think the children will definitely be impacted initially. There's no question about it. But we are prepared with the help of other superintendents and other districts across this great state to provide not only the school counselors, but the mental health support that not only our children need, but that our families need, our staff needs, our teachers, our bus drivers. I think we were all starting to figure out how much COVID impacted us as human beings and as an adult. We were just starting that process of understanding its impact to us. Now we're going to have to continue to support all individuals across this entire community to make sure the supports are there so that they can put their own lives together. Resiliency is something you have to practice. It's something you have to focus on. But this is an amazing community, and there's no question in my mind that this community will rise again. There's no question about it.
Do you ballpark have a sense at this point what percentage of the schools in Lee County suffered significant damage that's going to take long-term repair and recovery?
Again, with an untrained eye,
sure.
Right? Because if you want to talk about seventh grade math curriculum, I can help.
Yeah.
But with an untrained eye, but with the great respect to my principals and knowing and the building supervisors and the other individuals who work with our buildings every day, we have about 14 buildings that would be on that high needs list. We have about 43 to 45 that we believe could be operational. Again, the building inspectors will tell us. And then the remaining are in the middle, where they range from we're going to need to board up some windows until glass arrives, to they need to be significantly cleaned and cleaned out from tidal surge. Because remember, when the surge went over the outer island, it continued across the bay and into some of our schools. They were inaccessible for several days based upon water levels.
Mm-hmm. And lastly, I want to ask, have you been able to get in touch with your families? And I know a lot of people don't have internet. A lot of people are still maybe in a really tough spot. Have you been able to get in touch with families and see how the kids are doing within the district?
We have. Our first step was securing, this is a people business, right? And you always want to make sure you're taking care of all your people, and our children, our families, and this community are part of it. Our first step was to secure our own family, the family of the School District of Lee County. We reached out. We've located them. We know where they are. I just recently had a phone call with somebody who relocated to Atlanta. We didn't know that's where they had gone, but they knew they lived in a flooded area and they wanted to get further away. When cell service and other things had recovered enough inside Lee County, they made a phone call to me on Sunday. I now know where they are. We're about 98-99% of staff accounted for at this time. Now we're going to start making our turn towards our students and locating them and their families. Our plan is to put out surveys, and we understand with connectivity that could be an issue. We're going to use social media platforms, all platforms available, and we are working with the United Way and the 211 line to try to set up an opportunity for people to even call in and say, this is where we are. The form can get filled out, entered into the system, and we'll start a count. Mm-hmm. If I can, just real quickly, I've just been really impressed with Sanibel, Pine Island, so many of our other schools, including Fort Myers Beach Elementary. They've been reaching out. When I took that helicopter flight to the islands, they had already contacted probably 80-90% of their kids, and they knew they were okay. They're not local anymore, but they're okay, and we're hopeful that they'll return.
Very good. That's Lee County School Superintendent Christopher Bernier joining us live here on NBC2 and ABC7.